From this session, we will discuss about functions, default arguments, and return value, how unwritten complex objective numbers. Okay. First of all, we know what is function. From function, how we will going to be identify is a function. So function means there is a open phrase and close phrase of the symbol. It is there. So function we will going to use in R programming. Okay, the function is specifically for program environment, and also we have to use some set of instructions. So usually the function have two types. One is for predefined function, or the same time we can say already defined inside the program, so it can say inbuilt function. Okay, predefined function or inbuilt function. Then the second type, it is for user defined function. As a user, as a programmer, we going to design the function for our program, so it can say as a user defined function. So the predefined function and user defined function, it both will going to be work and support for your program. So based on the number of times execution, the same function going to be repeatedly many times we execution, we have to use call the function, and we have to reduce the or avoid the repetition of the same task, and also it can reduce the complexity of our programs. So the two things we will going to be used for using the function in R programming. Okay, so the function which we used for the specific task, and it may not be used as an argument. So we have to use argument inside the function, or it may be no need to use also. So the function can always use inside the program. So the program have whole structure, top, bottom, at the end. So the program we have is used for inside the body only. And we have used the function, it can use the return value. It may be the single return, or it may be the multiple returns. Both various category based on the program it will going to be implement. Okay, the syntax of functions. Okay, the function with argument list, so open phrase, then close phrase. Inside the open and close phrase we have to use for function, it can say function body. Okay, this general function based on the argument part is input, body, output. So only it can say this part is for input part, this part is for body part. Based on the input and body, we will got a output. Okay. So next there is a three categories of functions. So first we will use the initial function is built-in function. So already defined function we will take the example. Later we will go use the defined function. There is an inbuilt function in R. It may be the input parameter with the function arguments. So input parameter like A is our input 1. So now this A will going to occupy the function of that value. It's a parameter. So this variable is going to be considered as the 1 value. Okay. So this is our input. So this input will going to give an input of the program. Okay, so the program code as a source code function, or run the name of the function itself, it may be used for our console window. Okay, so there is a categories, there is a three group of functions with a category. So general function, mathematical function, and statistical function. So general function, in sense, it use the general concept of simple basic programs, like an example cbind, orbind, ranges, sorting the numbers, arranging the orders. So these are all the usual basic function using into the concept. So these functions like a specific task, taking the argument value and return the output of the functions. For example, see here there is a different function we will take. So in this function we will going to be identify the difference of the initial part and after doing the part. So it can work for time series, and it's going to be used for lag of variables. So it will going to be work from the different parts. So for example here the stationary process, even our taken example, then we can allow to construct the value like a mean, variance, autocorrelation values of overtiming we have to find. Okay, so this concept via we will going to be finding this function, and it can be improvement the prediction of time series. So based on the input we will going to be predict what will happen from the future. So it can easily done with the function and differences. So it can build the runtime series of data and train the user function differences in the stationary series. Okay, so for the next, see, from the function example here we will going to execute how it will be work. First we will have to set the time. Okay, so we have to ensure the same data. We will going to set the speed of the function. So the arbitrary values, the arbitrary value we will set 1, 2, 3. So the speed we will give the input is 1, 2, 3. So here we will take 1, 2, 3. So we will give the number of 1, 2, 3. Suppose if we have more other numbers or a large range, it may be given up. At the user view only. Okay. See, first we will load the value to set the seed function. So set seed equal to 1, 2, 3. This is range we have to set. After setting the function, we have to create the data. And we will going to give the normalization function. So based on this normalization value 1000, and it going to be take the input of x variable we have to load. So once we have to load at this value, it going to be take as a consume of the TS. The TS is equal to consume of that x digit. Okay, we will going to be get TS right now. So after we will find the differences of the TS. It will load the value TS differences. Okay, so once the value will be loaded, now you will going to be have a parameter for the rows, MF row. So that row value will going to be take the value of C as 1, 2. So now we will going to be plot the series based on the different value type 1 and type 2. So this will going to be plot the output. Okay, next example we will going to be see the length of the function. Suppose the length, so length of the function we will going to give an input like a, like a number, like a character. Okay, so now we will use the three things here. We will going to be use, this is our first, this is our second, this is our third. So totally we will have a length is 3. So here in the many cases we want to know the length of vectors from the compulsion. So we used for loop. First we will access the these value, is a loop first execution. Second we will load it here. Third we will load it here. So based on the loop we will going to take the length of the numbers. So the length function count the number of rows and vector of x. The following codes, see, these following codes will going to be take the input. For example, dt is equal to car. So the number of columns, see, these all the character became the single. So the input we will going to take as a number of columns, and the, what is the length of this dt? This dt is ever the value of one variable. So it will going to take the first digit of this one. So we will got the output is 1. Suppose what is the length of dt 1? The first row will going to be say the length which will load default value is 50. Okay, so it is the value can store the character. We will mention the number 1, the whole cars, but the length of character is 50. Okay. From this mathematical function, we will going to see the direct function for using the mathematical formulas. Like see absolute values, we will just give the value of x is equal to sum that numbers like a 100. This 100 value of absolute number we will going to be find. So we can use directly a, b, s. Inside that x digit, we will got the absolute value of x. Suppose we have to find the log value. So okay, log x, log base y. So the log x value is 100, base value is 10. We will got the value 10 is our the log and base digits. So we will got the value directly. For exponent value, so we will insert the x digit of that 100. We got the exponent value. Suppose square root. Suppose we will assign the value x is equal to 100. What is the square root of x? We will got the 10. We will get the x square root values. Like a same factorial. 10 a factorial. We will got the value in the factorial of 10. 10 into 9 into like we will get the output as a 10 factorial. See, like example here, now the values x vector. So this is our variable. So in this variable, we are going to be load the sequence of the value 45 to 55. So that range we will start from 45 and we will reach the range as a 55. So in this range of value, we will going to be load by the order of 1. So 45, 46, 47, and we will reach up to 55. So totally the 11 digits, we will going to take it as a here. So now these values are going to find the log. So now we will going to be take the value of 45, 55. So all the values we will going to take the log one by one. See, the first log output of 45 is here. Second value 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54 and 55. So totally we will start 45 to 55. All the digits will be loaded here as a square. So for the log value, the exponent value, we like say the exponent, we will got the exponent values output. So square root, we will got the square root value as a output. Factorial, we will got the factorial variable output. So like all the values, we will give the input once, but we will make a operation difference from here. Okay. See, the next one is for statistical functions. So already we will say three functions: general, mathematical, then last one is for the statistical function. This statistical function will going to work out for the mainly research focusing. The value which is for tables, we will going to be find the average, or we will going to find the mean, median, variance, standard deviation, scale values, or quadrant values, or summary of the whole digits. So we will going to be find based on the table, we will got the group of inputs, we can give an input and we will got the single output like mean, median, variance, so standard deviation. So all the categories of output we will got here. See, the example, speed is our values. This speed dt as a tables. Okay, so the table it's not mentioned here. Based on the some table output, we will got to find the mean value. So mean of that speed, we will got the output. The table is not mentioned here. So but the mean value is like an output. So meridian. So based on the meridian, we will find the meridian value of the speed. So we will got the output. So variance. So based on the variance speed, we will got the output. Okay, so we will just assume the table, but we will mention the output is here. So based on the input, suppose if you going to take any input table, then we will got based on the table, you got the output here. Okay, see here, there is a standard deviation. So standardization of vectors with the core values, we will have a large number of columns and large number of size of table will be there. Suppose we will got only first 5-6 place of the digit will be loaded in the head. Here there is a total size is 5, so we will print the 5 size of table. But it will have a load as a 6 is our head scalar value. Okay, so the quantum speed of that, that is showing the dividing the part of the 100, 75, 50%, 25, 0%. It will start as the lower percentage, it will reach as a higher percentage of the value. It will split up the quantum first meridian, third quadratic maximum. So all the values we will find it here as a summary of that speed table here. Okay, like the books which we refer and textbook are mentioned here. Based on your need, you have to use it. Okay, thank you all.